Ori, let's talk about hats that are best for windy days.
Oh my gosh. Now that the fall's coming up, I think that's a great conversation to have.
Is it important to get a hat with a chin strap?
Ooh, great question. So we've got hundreds of styles. Now, not every hat has a chin strap, but I'll be honest with you, I don't wear hats with chin straps. I'm gonna talk to you a little bit today about the different hats with chin straps and hats without chin straps. The chin straps, in my opinion, kind of get in the way. Now, what I do is I wear a hat that fits pretty snug, not tight. You know, what I call that when you've got too tight of a hat, I call it a PH crown. You know, other companies have different style crowns. I just call our crown that's too tight a PH, permanent headache. If I do end up with a hat that has a chin strap, usually what I do is I tuck it up behind me because I personally don't use it that often. And I don't like it resting on the back of my head or hanging down in front of me. So I tuck it up off the back just like that. And then I've got it right there. But I'll tell you that the way we fit most of our hats is they've got a double contour. So they really wrap to your head. So different hats have different contours and that really plays into the fit factor. So what I'd like to show you now, if you'll help me out, is I've got a hat on right now. I'm not using the chin strap, and let's do a little wind test. As you can see, that was one of our lightest hats, the Crusher. This hat is actually an extra large, and I wear an extra large, and that hat did not come off. So I'll tell you that you don't always need a chin strap. Now, there's other ways to go about that because everybody has different feelings. You know, some people like a looser hat. And so what I've seen people do is with our sweat liners, they'll get a hat that's a little too big for them because they don't want that permanent headache crown. They'll pop out the thin sweat liner and they'll put in one of our thicker sweat liners. And what I'll show you here is there's a different thickness between all three of these. If you take these here, you can see there's a little bit of a difference in thickness on each one of these. The middle one being the thinnest standard sweat liner, the brown one out here on your left being the medium sized sweat liner, and then the thickest one being gray out here on your right. What they'll then do is take that thicker sweat liner. So that doesn't really shrink the circumference of the hat. What it ends up doing is just kind of tightening it up a little bit. So it's still an incredibly comfortable hat, but it's nice and tight. So this hat's a little too big for me, but with that thicker sweat liner, it's gonna hold it on pretty good. So let's do another wind test, Yanni, and see if this hat stays on.
Oh yeah.
So with that said, what you guys will see is that we truly do have hats that will stay on your head no matter what the wind case situation you might have. So then once again, cruise our website, check them out. If you want a chin strap, by all means get one. And if you don't, because you can see these work.
Move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way. Move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch.
And for the record, these hats are waterproof.
Don't bring everybody. Don't wear it. It will soon pass, whatever it is. Don't worry, be happy.